Great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Georgetown Hoyas and the Maryland Terrapins. And here's a look at our Star Watch comparison. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Mr. Nestler, I like the matchup at the small forward position. Definitely two of the higher-rated players on the floor. Definitely a matchup we should continue to look at.
Well, Dick, we've got two top-ranked teams going head-to-head. This should be a great game.
I tell you, it's always exciting to watch two teams battle for a chance to move up the polls. People across the nation will be watching this one.
Looks like they're going to go with a full-court man-to-man press, Dick. The Hoyas are currently ranked number 24 in the nation, Dick.
Hey, one thing that every team in the top 25 has is really essential guard play. You better excel on a perimeter to have a shot.
There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
I think he was there, Dick.
Yeah, but that could have gone either way.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
The Hoyas set up in their zone motion. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He attempts the jump shot.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Tries for two. That one's off. For two, scorches the net. Running that Princeton offense here.
I'll tell you, that Princeton offense drives you bananas. Look at the way they spread the court. Tremendous spacing, great execution, and they read so exceptionally well. Any mistake the defense makes, it is absolute great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here, I'm the landlord.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Goes in. On the outside. Let's watch the move as he works his man and on a fadeaway jumper. A little two-man action. Inside. He shoots the jumper. Off the mark. Number zero receives the ball. They work the perimeter. For the bucket, it sticks.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper. Terrell's mediocre play has really gotten to him.
Brad, I see a young man who's struggling at both ends of the court. Human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots. They have one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. Experience is so important, Brad. See situations and knowing how to react to them correctly and quickly is a great, great thing.
Second shot, no good. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Tries for two. Nice shot. Now that was a great play right there, Dick.
Well, they're doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
8 minutes left in the game clock.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He manages to keep it in play. And we'll head back down to the other end. Moving it around the perimeter. He launches a three. Can't connect. Gave it up. Seven minutes left on the game clock. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. For two, it's good. The dribble, gives it up. He unloads. Off the mark. Well, here's a look at the tempo for both teams tonight, Dick.
You know, it's crucial, Brad, that both teams stick to their style of play. If not, the chances of them winning definitely decreases.
Cross court. Goes up for two. The shot won't fall. Terrell handles the feed. Both teams looking to get things going here. On the outside, 6 minutes left on the game clock. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
I'm sorry, Brad, but this young fella seems to be their only hope at the moment.
Number 10 takes the pass. Gave it up. Copeland picks up the foul. He gets the layup to go and the foul.
What a hoop. He saw the defender coming and tried to go right through him.
Well, Dick, as mentioned earlier, these are two of the better teams in the country. What do you make of this matchup so far?
You know, Brad, as expected, it's pretty close. This is a great test for both teams. It gives them a chance to really measure how they compare to other top teams.
There's a reason they're called free throws. On the dribble, gives it up. Number 12 is whistled for the foul. Second team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
The second shot. Gave it up. With tons of room, nails the jumper. Talk about being a tough place to play. Check out this arena.
Hey, this is what you call a hostile environment, Mr. Nestler. Not only is this crowd loud, but they give their team that next level of energy that lasts all game long.
And back they come the other way. Looking for a good shot. Hard foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, here's a player in just his freshman year.
Hey, being a student in college is quite an experience, but being a student athlete is something on a whole other level. There are a lot of challenges you have to meet if you want to keep your balance and be successful.
He missed it. He takes the board. They work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Nope. They clear the defensive rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
On the dribble, gives it up. About 4 minutes remaining.
There's the trap.
Number zero is called for the foul. First personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, that's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
Opportunity now for an easy one. He can't get one to fall. In some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad.
Gave it up. He pulls up with a jumper. Jumper won't go. Now let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
And it's knocked loose. Dribble, gives it up, takes his jumper, gets the J to fall. 3 minutes left on the game clock.
Up and inside.
The fadeaway jumper busts the fadeaway J. Working it around the perimeter. Takes the jumper. Scores it. Terrible execution on offense. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Unusual mistake there by the senior.
Out on the wing. Buries it. The Hoyas did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
Well, they're doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Looking for a good shot.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
He tries the jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Turns it over. They'll work it around the arc. We're at the 1 minute mark. The small forward receives the ball. They work it around the perimeter. He puts up the three ball. Nails the J. Now trying to feed the low block. Tries for two. Makes the shot. Shot clock is dead.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
And the slam. At the end of the first half, the Terrapins are ahead by five. Maryland really showed no signs of rust with their shooting in the first half, Dick.
They certainly didn't. Their offensive execution was near perfection. Keeping it up will be the key.
Before we go any further, let's take a moment here and have a look at our game summary.
I've been really impressed with just how hard both teams are playing. These numbers show you how they've been performing.
Comes back out onto the floor.
Major swing in energy with him back on the floor, Brad.
Going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. Gave it up. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up-and-under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up-and-under move to utilize good footwork.
Cross court. He attempts the three. Missed it.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots from the corner. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Going to move it around the perimeter and come up short. Had a momentary look from three-point land. For the bucket. Gets it to go.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
On the outside. Goes up for two. He's money with the shot. Trying to feed the low block for the bucket. Off the glass and no good. Challenging like that really makes the offense think twice about putting the shot up.
It's really almost as good as a block.
The point guard with the ball. Tries for two. He nails the shot. The Hoyas did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
They work the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. The missed shot. they work it around the perimeter.
That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane, anticipating really well.
Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He puts up the J. Looks like the defender's a little bit tired out there.
This is no time to be tired. Get a sub if you need a break.
And there's a lazy pass, it's stolen away. Turnover, will it turn into two the other way? They'd like to get it inside to the low block. He goes up with it, missed the jumper. Puts it up. Around 8 minutes remaining for two. Sinks the shot. The shooting guard gets the ball. Bust the J. The Terrapins did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
The turn, a fadeaway jumper.
You talk about versatility. There aren't many guys that are going to make that fadeaway jump shot. Great touch. Impossible to block that shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. He drains this shot. The Hoyas are a half-court team, Dick. What are some of the components that make up a good half-court team?
Hey, based on what we've seen in their personnel, the half-court style suits them well, Brad. They really rely on spacing and team offensive concepts to score. Longer, drawn-out possessions, as opposed to quick shots, is definitely their style.
The small forward gets the ball.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. With a bucket, that's good. Gave it up.
Great job of rotating back. Now they got numbers.
6 minutes left on the game clock. Moving it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Not this time. Out on the right wing.
Trying to go inside.
There's the block. On the left wing, on the outside, puts up the J.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Looking for a good shot. From way outside, off the mark. We're at the 5 minute mark. They work it around the perimeter. Loose ball and batted in. And the ball is dribbled out of play. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
It's been great to watch them move the ball like that, and they're doing all the things it takes to win. They're committed to playing good team defense, and when your team is doing those type of things, you're smiling as a coach.
Here comes the ball screen. The shooting guard with the ball. Nope. into the low block. He shoots. This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
It's crazy in here, Brad.
Inside. Blocked. Hayes getting after it and saves it. And once again, our two featured players here in tonight's Star Watch. Ball's coming from the sideline. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. And makes it.
Up and inside.
For two. Off the glass and no good. An absolute stranglehold by the defense so far tonight.
Hey, the other team is responding by throwing up quick shots, which is exactly what the defense wants.
Tries and the block. He grabs the board. Terrell handles the feed. He tries the jumper. Nails the J. On the wing. Working it around the perimeter. About 3 minutes remaining. On the dribble, gives it up. For the deuce. With a layup. Gave it up. The three. He drains the jumper. The Terrapins were going to have to alter their style of play and play primarily in the half court from here on out, Dick.
They should definitely consider running longer half court sets at this point. The time and score are in their favor.
Swatted away. The Hoyas are going to have to make a move here and make a move fast. Playing in the half court is no longer an option, Dick. They've got to get some quick scores.
You got it, Brad. They may have to extend their defense and really look to trap in order to force some turnovers. They need points.
We're at the 2 minute mark. Cross court. Two off the backboard. That kid's making him think about every shot, Dick.
And he's doing it without fouling, which is the key.
Now looking to create with a ball screen.
Hey, the pick and roll is one play that so many teams use these days. A great way to buy a step for the dribbler.
It's a 9-point lead.
Well, 9 points still keeps you in the game, though, Brad. They can't have a breakdown here, though.
Out on the wing. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Makes the shot. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Trying to pack it inside. Goes up. Off the glass. Timeout on the floor. ESPN's coverage of the NCAA will continue after this. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Looking for a good shot. He unloads a three. He misses the J. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again. To the charity stripe. He can't buy one. They're not getting the balls to fall from the line.
Hey, if I were the coach of this team, I would make them run so many lines, I would pass out from watching them run, Brad.
After the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. Zone motion now. On the right side. He unloads a three. Shot clock is dead. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
Steps to the line for an easy one. No good.
A Buccaneer is crucial.
Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball, take care of the ball.
He is really earning his paycheck today, that's for sure.
Hey, Brad, the coaching staff has a job to do, and that is to ensure that the players are prepared. There's always so much going on, and as a player, you need someone on the sidelines constantly giving you guidance.
What kind of energy are we looking at after that timeout, Dick?
That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
Got it. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. At the free throw line. Makes the front end of the 1-1. He misses the second. This team has got to be so frustrated. They are terrible at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Frustration only makes it worse, Brad. They have to figure out what they're doing wrong and fix it.
The players got a much-needed breather with that timeout. The Hoyas set up in their zone motion. Tries the three. Can't connect. And the clock stopped with a foul. Well, this is now one of the better free-throw shooting teams in college basketball, that's for sure.
Free throw shooting is probably one of the things that the coaching staff would love to improve upon. They realize the importance of being able to knock down free throws.
He misses it. A less than stellar performance, I'd say, at the line tonight.
Less than stellar? You're too nice a guy, Brad. They're shooting horribly from the line tonight.
Game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
The Hoyas now running a zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
The free throw line. Opportunity. He hits the first shot. No finish on that one. And that free throw line has really not been friendly for them tonight, Nick.
Yeah, they just haven't looked comfortable from there.
We'll see who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the York.
He puts it up at the horn. Rims out. And here, Dick, we have our players of the game.
Just two great players with some fantastic performances here tonight.